Hello students, good morning. I am Mandeep Singh Thakur, assistant professor in electrical engineering department at Chandigarh Polytechnic College, Dhuwa. In this lecture, we are studying about the sources of energy. There are many sources of electrical energy, but we are studying about the conventional and non-conventional, both type of sources. Let us start with PPT. As per the subject of installation and maintenance of electrical engineering equipment, it is the basic lecture about the power generation. In this lecture, we are studying about the sources of energy. Let us start. Power generation in electrical engineering. Introduction. The main function of power generation is to generate electric power. They convert latent energy into mechanical energy, which is further used to drive the generator. The latent energy may be of coal, uranium, water. The equipment which is used for driving the generator is known as prime mover. These prime movers get energy from various sources. Like sources of energy. The main sources of energy are sun, wind, water, fuel, and atomic energy. In this, we will explain these one by one. The first is sun, the wind, ocean tides and waves, water, fuels, and nuclear energy. These are the basic resources which are used to convert mechanical energy into electrical energy by the use of these sources. The first one is sun. This is the primary source of energy. The heat energy radiated by the sun can be focused over a small area by means of reflectors, silicon reflectors. This heat energy is further utilized for raising the steam. The electrical energy can be produced with help of turbine alternator set. The main advantage of this energy is it is a natural source and free to air or free in abundant amount. The another advantage is it is available in plenty, means in bulk, in nature. The next advantage is it is non-polluting because there is no combustion by using this energy when we use this type of energy. It does not emit any greenhouse gases. If there is no combustion and no emission of greenhouse gases. The next advantage is it does not result in the destruction of forests and ecosystems that occurs with most fossil fuel operations. With the advantage, it also have some disadvantage. Here we go. Disadvantages of sun energy. Dependent on change in seasons, weather. Hence, they may not be used always. Because in rainy season or cloudy weathers, we not get the energy from sun. So, we are not used it always. The second advantage, disadvantage is requires high initial investments for productive use. The installation of plant is consumed high initial cost. So it is not possible for everyone to make use of this energy. The third disadvantage is solar systems does not work at night directly, but the battery bank, which stores energy during daytime and can be used during night. It also increase the battery uses also increase the cost of this project. The next disadvantage is solar electricity storage technology has not reached its potential yet. So it is not economical. The third and next disadvantage is solar panels are bulky. This is particularly true of the higher efficiency. Traditional silicon crystalline wafer solar modules are used to convert this light energy or heat energy to electrical energy. And the next source is wind. Wind is the natural movement of air across the land or sea. The wind, when used to turn the blades of a windmill, turns the shaft to which they are attached. This movement of shaft through a pump or generator produces electricity. It is the basic working of this energy. The main advantage of this type of energy or wind energy is it's freely and abundantly available or in huge amount in nature. The next and major advantage is it is environment friendly because there is no combustion, and if there is no combustion, no release of no emission of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Same. The disadvantage, the next is that there are some disadvantages as well as of this energy. The first one is high investment required because the windmill installation, generator installation, it consumes the huge amount of the cost is become high. The second and major disadvantage is wind speed is not uniform at all the time, which affects power generation because the number of revolutions we required to move the generator is not uniform. The next type of energy is the ocean tides and waves. A small dam with larger gates can be made across the mouth of the bay, and low head turbines are installed in it. At the time of high tides, the gates are open and water is stored in the tidal basin, and then gates are closed. When we put the water on the basin, after that we close the gates. The next one is there is a hydraulic head between basin water and open ocean. The stored water is now allowed to flow back to ocean through hydraulic turbine installed at the dam. By this process, power generation is possible continuously, both during high tide and low tide. It is the basic process for tide waves or ocean tides. How we can use this energy to convert it in electrical energy. The next is water. Electrical energy can be generated by driving water turbines coupled to generators. This water energy is converted into mechanical energy by means of water turbines. These turbines run the alternator, which generate electrical energy. There are some advantages of this energy. It does not require any fuel because water turbines are used to generate electrical energy from water flow, potential energy to kinetic energy. Next is, no fuel means no fuel cost, means running cost of this type of plant is low. The next one is, there is no combustion because water is used to run the water turbines. Next is, no generation of flue gases. Students, if there is a no combustion, then no fluent gases comes out. The next is, no pollution in the atmosphere. As per same, if there is a no combustion, then no pollution comes to atmosphere. And the last is, it's freely and available in huge amount or abundantly available. There are some disadvantages as well as the first and major disadvantage is initial cost is high because of construction of a huge dam to store the water in the reservoir. And after that, for the outlet points, we need or we have to require the rivers to flow the water after the operation. And the next is, long transmission lines are required because these plants are situated near the hilltops or hilly areas. So long transmission lines are required to took the electricity from hillside to load side or up to the consumer end. So transmission cost is also high. The next type of energy is fuel. The fuels may be solid fuels as coal, liquid fuels as oil, and gas fuel as natural gas. The heat energy of these fuels is converted into mechanical energy by means of prime movers. These prime movers are coupled to alternators, which further convert mechanical energy into electrical energy. There are some advantages of fuel. Fossil fuel can generate a large amount of electricity at a single location. This is the big and major advantage. The second one is, they can be found very easily. They are cost effective. Transportation of oil and gas can be done easily through the pipelines. And the next advantage is, they have become safer over a long time or long time period. And these are some disadvantages to use the fuel type of energies. The first one is, fossil fuels emit carbon dioxide and burn, which is a major greenhouse gas and the primary source of pollution. This has contributed to global warming. As per the combustion took place there to burn the fuel, then the greenhouse gases released in the atmosphere after the combustion of the fuel. So it is a major issue. because it increase the global warming also. The second disadvantage is they are a non-renewable resource. Means once used, they cannot be replaced or used again for a long period. The third major disadvantage is the combustion of fossil fuel. The third major disadvantage is the combustion of fossil fuels makes the environment more acidic. This has led to unpredictable and negative changes in the environment. The last but not least, harvesting of fossil fuels also causes fatal disease among the people. For example, the coal miners often suffer from black lung disease. The natural gas drillers are constantly exposed to chemicals and silica, which is dangerous for their health. These are the some issues with this type of energy. And the next one is nuclear energy. Nuclear energy is used to produce electricity in huge amount. Heat generated from the splitting of uranium atoms in a process known as fission is used to produce steam. This steam in turn power turbines, which are used to produce the electricity that supplies the surrounding communities. This is a basic process, and with this there are some advantages of this energy. The first one is, it is estimated that 1 kg of nuclear fuel is equivalent to the heat produced by 4,500 tons of coal. It is a major amount. With small fuel, we can convert it in large amount of heat production. The next is reliable. It is stored and reliable. The next advantage is no greenhouse gases effect, because in this process we took the fission reaction. There are some disadvantages as well for nuclear type of plants. The first is very high initial cost. The cost of the uranium fuel is very high and it is not available easily. The next disadvantage is problem of disposal of radioactive waste. When we use the nuclear energy or uranium for the production of electricity, the chemical or chambers or equipment come directly in this used directly in this type of energy, or during the fission reaction they become radioactive, and it is the major issue to dispose the radioactive waste. The last disadvantage is need of trained persons to handle the plant. Means the specialist engineers or staff is required, because the fission reaction is very dangerous and we need to require to control this reaction or in control rate for the production of electricity. Thank you. If you have any queries or question, you may free to ask. Thank you.